Good morning, children. Today we are going to begin the next chapter, geometry. Here we are going to first revise what are the basic concepts of geometry. First is point. A point shows exact location and it represented by a dot, and we used to name it by a cap letter, any cap letter. So a dot shows exact location, a point means it shows an exact location. Next topic is line segment. So line segment, we can say it is a shortest distance between the two points. It has a definite length. It is named by its end points, and we will denoting it by AB. The above AB we will denote it by a line, so we call it as a line segment. The next topic is line. A line goes along a straight path in both the direction. It has no end. So a line, it does not have any end, no end. So a line is named by two points on it, and we will denote it by the two sides. Both the sides it will be denoted by an arrow. That means it goes on. It has no end. Then intersecting lines. If you have a two intersecting line, the lines will cross each other like this. If you look at the picture, you can understand two lines cross each other at a particular point. So we call that as a intersecting point, and the lines we call it as an intersecting lines. Parallel lines. These lines never meet each other, but they will be always at an equal distance from each other. We call that it as a parallel line. Parallel line example they have shown here. See, look at the railway track. So they will go each other side by side, but they will not meet any point, and they will always travel at an equal distance. Equal distance. So the best example for parallel lines is railway tracks. So these are the basic concepts. And perpendicular lines, two lines intersecting at right angle, we call it as an perpendicular lines. Next, array. Array is a part of line. It begins at a point, goes endlessly. So it starts at a point and it will go endlessly. This is the difference between the line and the ray. So the ray, both the side it will go endless line, and ray, one side it has a starting point, another side only it will go endless. Then next topic is angle. So what do you mean by an angle? When two rays meet at a common point, we call it as a vertex. That common point we will call it as a vertex, and the two lines we will call it as an arm, and we will denote it by a symbol like this, a crocodile mouth symbol. So we have the next topic is types of angles. So you all know right angle, acute angle, obtuse angle, the basic types of angle. Right angle means it look like this, two lines like the corner of a rectangular shaped door, like L shape. This corner we will denote it as a right angle. It is 90 degree. Then when you see a straight angle, the two right angles make a straight angle. This side one right angle, this side one right angle. So right angle as 90 degree, so two right angles, so it is 180 degree. An acute angle means an angle less than a right angle. So right angle will be like L shape, and the angle less than right angle we call all the angles is acute angle. And the angle more than right angle, see, look at the L shape is like this, it is crossing the L. So the angle which is more than right angle we call it as an obtuse angle. So today's class we have learned the basic concepts and types of angles. So you learn these concepts as well as the types of angles. The important thing is acute angle, straight angle, right angle, obtuse angle. these concepts be thorough with this. And exercise 9.1, color the right angle as green, acute angle as red, and obtuse angle as blue. You are going to color it in your book. So first we will check right angle with green. So this is a right angle. Picture number 4 is a right angle. So you are going to color this angle place with green. Next is acute angle. We are going to color the angle place as a red. So this is an acute angle red. Here one acute angle is there red. So this is also an acute angle red. Then obtuse angle, obviously 2 and a 5. So you are going to color it as a blue. So in your book you color it. So with this our class gets over. You're going to learn the types of angles and the basic concepts of geometry, and you're going to learn this exercise 9.1 A problem. Thank you, students.